phone for you.
Jack, we still have high radiation on level 8.
Perfectly normal.
Feed water flow 450,000 pounds per hour and it's decreasing.
Get out of here.
Jack, Bill Gibson in the district's gallery.
Yep.
We got some people here from Channel 3. They're shooting a TV news special at the plant. Listen, what the hell's going on down there?
It's just a routine turbine trip, Bill. Okay? So just take it easy. There's nothing to worry about.
High water level in the reactor.
We're still on main artillery power.
Okay, relax. Everybody relax. Got high water in the core and I'm going to dump it. There's nothing to worry about. It's just a routine turbine trip. Let me see if you can find out where that goddamn water's coming from. Wherever it's coming from, we got to get rid of it. Look at this, Ted. Hey, Barney.
Yo.
Open 14 and 15.
You can't do that, Jack.
Open them, Barney.
Jack, you can't do it. The book says
well,
you can't
the
do
book.
It.
We're almost up to the steam lines.
Those flashing lights are called annunciators. When they're activated, it means something in the plant needs some attention. There's obviously a lot of activity, but Goodell says it's routine. He's a good man, Goodell. He was a commander of a submarine in the nuclear navy. We have these turbine trips a couple times a year.
What's a turbine trip?
Well, that means the turbine is no longer turning because the steam has been shut down.
Hey, Jack.
What?
Look at this water level indicator. Water level's low.
This says it's high.
Oh, that's it.
Jesus Christ!
Water, Barney, give me some water! God damn it!
Ted, we may uncover the core.
Operations.
This is Jack Goodell. We have a serious condition. You get everybody into safety areas and make sure that they stay there.
I don't know. They might have come close to exposing the core.
If that's true, then we came very close to the China syndrome.
The what?
If the core is exposed, for whatever reason, the fuel heats beyond core heat tolerance in a matter of minutes. Nothing can stop it. And it melts right down through the bottom of the plant, theoretically, to China. But
the antipodes of Harrisburg is in the Indian Ocean. The reactor core would not defy gravity to pass beyond the Earth's center. Any Jane Fonda China reference is noteworthy.
Of course, as soon as it hits groundwater, it blasts into the atmosphere and sends out clouds of radioactivity. The number of people killed would depend on which way the wind is blowing. Render an area the size of Pennsylvania permanently uninhabitable, not to mention the cancer that would show up later.
It was the first step in a nuclear nightmare. As far as we know, at this hour, no worse than that. But a government official said that a breakdown in an atomic power plant in Pennsylvania today is probably the worst nuclear reactor accident to date. There was no apparent serious contamination of workers, but a nuclear safety group said that radiation inside the plant is at 8 times the deadly level, so strong that after passing through a 3-foot-thick concrete wall, it can be measured a mile away.